morning. Glad you're here. Well, my name is Jamie. I'm one of the animal care specialists here at the park. And I get the pleasure of working with our California sea lions, harbor seals, and penguins every single day. And so today, you guys are going to get introduced to one of our amazing sea lions named Easton. He'll be headed down here shortly. I just want to introduce myself and just give you guys a heads up and make sure you guys stay behind the chains at all times for your safety and for our California sea lions as well. You might notice another lovely fellow behind me. His name is Sheldon. He's one of our male harbor seals that calls Gulf Coast home. Sheldon was born at another facility, and now he is 9 years old, and we're so proud to call him our marine animal family. And here joining us today is Trainer Kelsey with Easton, the California Sea Lion. Wow. Now, Easton was born at SeaWorld of Orlando, and he's been living here with us since he was about a year old. He's currently 12 years old, and we're so proud to have him as part of our marine mammal family. So let's make some noise. Nice job, guys. Now, Easton here is a male California sea lion. He's a little bit different than what Sheldon looks like. When you guys walk up here later, you'll be able to see some of those different qualities. But Easton here is definitely a sea lion. He has different attributes than a seal, one of them being his ears. You'll notice on the side of his head that he has external ear flaps known as pinnae. Seals, however, lack these pinnae and instead just have tiny holes on the side of their head that just leads to an internal ear. That's one way you can tell them apart. Now, also, you'll notice that he has some very long front flippers. Easton here has 5 bony digits inside of those front flippers, making him very strong and athletic. He can use these front flippers to hold 100% of his body weight. Now, these front flippers are used to be able to pull themselves through the water at a top speed of 6 to 8 miles per hour. So he's gonna basically swim by using those front flippers to propel himself through the water. If you were looking at a seal though, they don't have these very long front flippers. Instead, they just have short, stubby front flippers that they use to turn and steer while swimming in the water. They'll also use them to maybe help them climb out onto land as well. Now this is just a clue to our last big difference for a seal and a sea lion, and that's going to be their hind hip bone. Sea lions have a rotating hind hip bone, which means that they can tuck their hind flippers up underneath their body, giving themselves lift to walk, run, hop, and even climb while on land. So Easton here is extremely agile, and he's got some pretty good dance moves as well. Let's see how fast he is. Easton's got some pretty good dance moves both in the water and on land. So we love training these guys' new behaviors. That is definitely the most fun part of my job, is working with these guys each and every day, just like Kelsey's doing right now. And you might be wondering, how does Easton learn all these amazing behaviors? Well, it's actually just using positive reinforcement. Whenever he does something correct, he's going to get something he likes, which of course is fish, that's right. Not just any fish, though. It is 5-star restaurant quality fish. So it's the best stuff. We come in at 7 a.m. bright and early every day and sort through hundreds of pounds of fish for all of our animals here in the park. So Ethan's eating quite a bit of food right now, and just depending on the season, he'll eat a little more or a little less. So this time of year, it's a little bit chillier outside, so of course he's going to want to pack on that weight so he has more blubber to stay warm. Now you'll also notice that Easton has some whiskers on his front of his face. Those whiskers are also known as vibrissae. Both species of pinniped have this. In fact, there are 3 species of pinniped. You've got the seals, sea lions, and walrus. Now here at Gulf World, we just have 2 subspecies. We have the California sea lion and the harbor seal. Both these guys are commonly found on the west coast for California sea lions, all the way from Baja, Mexico to Canada. But for a seal like Sheldon, well, he's showing off himself pretty well now for you guys. You can find these guys both on the east and west coast of North America, more in the northern region. They like the chillier weather, for sure. Now, another really cool feature I love about the California sea lion is hearing the roar. Do you guys think he has a mighty roar? Yeah. Sheldon does not. He makes chuck and grunt sounds, but Easton here can make a very loud sound, and he'd love to share that with you guys today. That was a mighty roar. Very well done. Now these guys will use
use their loud barking sounds to be able to protect maybe their territory for males. And if they're females, well, of course, they're maybe calling out to their pups or trying to find or locate their pups on the large beaches. Make sure everybody stay behind the chains for me, guys. Thank you so much. Now, also, you'll notice that he does have fur. They're not like dolphins where they're just nice and rubbery skin, but these guys have short fur, and they will actually molt by season every year, and they'll just lose a little bit of time and get a brand new coat, making them nice and spiffy and ready for the new season. Now, Easton here is weighing close to 400 pounds. Sea lions like Easton can get up to 600 to 800 pounds, just depending on where they're located and how much they're eating. Now, Ethan here does good weight right now, especially with it being a growing boy. We also have a small sea lion named Salsa, who is a rescued animal. She stranded on the coast of California when she was just a pup, and she was entangled in fishing line. So that's why it's super important to make sure we keep our beaches clean to help protect sea lions like Ethan and Salsa. But Salsa is much smaller, weighing at about 130 pounds, so she's very tiny. But females will only weigh about 220 pounds once they're full grown. Now, Ethan has good eyes both above and below the water, but we can actually give them eye drops to make sure that their eyes are staying nice and healthy. This is one of the reasons why we train, and probably one of the most important reasons. We want to make sure that our animals are extremely healthy. We're looking them over from head to tail each and every day, making sure there are no cuts, no bruises, that that Ethan is a perfect-looking guy, and making sure that they stay healthy. So we're also looking for any illnesses. We have a veterinarian right on site, so if anything were to come up that we see abnormal behavior from Easton, well, then we can just talk to our veterinarian, they can look at him immediately. Now, this also means we can train for husbandry behaviors, things like a voluntary layout like Easton was just doing. This is super important because we can actually get a voluntary blood sample by having them be nice and calm like this. We can do radiographs, ultrasound, you name it, it probably can be trained as long as we desensitize the equipment that we use to being able to get a reading on whatever health we're looking at. So it's pretty amazing. But training is simply as 1, 2, 3s. We just basically make sure that whenever he does something we're asking for, we make sure we reinforce positively. And if he's wrong or incorrect, that's okay. We're simply going to pause a moment and then move on to something more positive, making sure that he knows that it's okay to fail, but you'll have another chance at being successful. And if he needs a pause or a break, well, then we can do that as well, too, a positive step back to let him know it's okay, we're going to try again in a few. Now, we'll train also for mental stimulation. We want to make sure that these guys are constantly thinking it's not the same thing every day. That'd be really boring, right? Especially for us that are in school, any kids out there, definitely want to make sure it's a little different and variable for our animals as well. We want to make sure that they are learning new behaviors and not just doing the same thing every single day. So Ethan here is learning different behaviors with all of us as trainers. And it's our job to, as well, whatever they have already learned, to make sure we're keeping up on those behaviors too. And then probably the last big reason why we will train is for physical exercise. We want to make sure these guys are being exercised every single day, because that's good cardiovascular exercise right there. Make sure they're doing their speed swims or whatever they've learned to make sure they burn some energy. Nothing better than a good speed swim, right, Ethan? All right. Well, Ethan has done an amazing job out here. And we want to thank you guys so much for joining us this morning to meet Easton and learn a lot about California sea lions. He says the same thing. So he's actually going to go back upstairs and hang out with some other animals. We love have a lot of different habitats upstairs where we can have a lot of other seals and sea lions. So we want to make sure that he's keeping it variable for him to come down here and join with you guys. Well, that's extremely variable to come down here and then go back upstairs for him. So that's what he's doing, is he's going to head on back upstairs. We want to thank you guys so much for joining us today. We hope you enjoy the rest of your day here at Golf World. If you have any questions, my name is Jamie once again, and I'll be happy to answer any of those questions. Thanks, guys. Thank you.